Stephen Jill here.
Hi.
Welcome to the Land Academy Show, entertaining land investment talk. I'm Stephen Jack Butella.
And I'm Jill DeWitt, broadcasting from sunny Southern California.
Today, Jill and I talk about how to sell and record the same day.
What does that mean?
Go ahead.
You want to explain what that is?
Sure.
Okay.
So in every real estate transaction, you purchase a property, and then you have to get it recorded at the county. Mm-hmm. You do some marketing, you resell the property to the new buyer, and you have to record it at the county. I think it goes without saying, the faster that this process happens, the better.
Exactly.
So what Jill's done and what we do now almost regularly because of, I think, electronic recording. Is that mm-hmm. what this is about?
Yes, it is.
Jill's going to describe
it. How are you doing here today? Let's take a moment. Can we talk about this for just a second? How are you? How are you?
I'm great.
Okay, good.
What does that mean?
Well, like, you wrote the topic and you're checking with me. I'm just making fun. It's good.
The deeper meaning to this is that the faster the real estate deal, the better.
Yeah. That's really it.
To get all philosophical about it, that the velocity of money is very much alive and well and at work churning real estate deals. But there's a lot of details that are involved when you're doing this deal, like recording the same day. Some of the back-end administrative stuff is really what can drag a deal out, not so much the raw supply and demand.
Right.
And so
let's do the question and let's get into it on the show.
Sounds good.
All right.
Let's take a question posted by one of our members on the landinvestors.com online community. It's free.
Daniel asks, what flat rate MLS providers have you heard of or have you used that were of value to your land sales? I've heard of the following from other land investors. We have Broker Direct, MLS.com. I like them. CongressRealty.com. I like them also. Please share your experience. Okay. So what this is, it's in land sales, when depending on the price point, you may or may not want to do this. So let me just start with that. What it is putting your property in the MLS. Back in the day, you used to have to list it with a broker or a realtor, some kind of agent to get access to get into the MLS. And then part of the deal is automatically to get a piece of the action, they get a commission. So that would obviously, if you have a $2,000 property, a couple things would, you know, make it not cost worthy. One, they don't want to do it because on the commission on a $2,000 property is not much. And B, you only have a $2,000 property. You don't want to give up part of your commission from what you're selling. You know, if you bought it for $500 and you're selling it for $2,000 and you have to give, you know, $600 to an agent or something, whatever they think is worthy of doing this, it didn't make a lot of sense, right? There goes your profits. So what this is nowadays, there are a bunch of brokers out there and it's legal and it's so cost effective that they just say, hey, you know what? I'll provide you my services of giving you access to the MLS through me for a flat rate. And what that means is they're not marketing it. They're not going to promote it. They're not going to sell it. They're not even going to answer the phone for you. They're, you know, it's all you. All they're doing is saying, here, I'll give you the form. You fill this out like I would be doing myself, and I will get it transferred in the MLS for you. And it's great. And so I love Broker Direct. MLS is a great service.
Yeah.
And also we've used them many times. And I would start there with Congress Realty because you can look between the two. They vary based on the state, based on the coverage, based on the access that they have negotiated on the MLS pricing in those different states and areas. So that's why you'll see difference in prices. But between the two, sorry.
It's okay. Difference, there's a pretty serious difference between the two. First of all, it's geography based. Congress Realty is really only the western part of the country. Broker Direct MLS, in addition to getting a property into the MLS for a fixed price, syndicates it everywhere. Mm-hmm. Land and Farm, Land Watch. There's a ton of places where they'll post your property for you.
Congress does that too.
Oh, do they?
Yes, they do. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, how it works is like Congress is one of the places that Broker Direct might sub the workout to. So Broker Direct really works with all these different little guys, and it's just the one that we happen to know really well.
I mean, what does Congress. It cost? Like $200?
Anywhere from $99 to $400 is what I've seen.
Okay.
So you need to, and you can go look and check it out real quick before you decide, you know, if it makes sense.
Here's what's great about getting your property into the MLS in general. The way that we buy and sell property in our group, houses, land, whatever, it's almost always the cheapest property. So if you're like me, you're going to go on the internet and you buy anything. You look for the cheapest thing first, just mm-hmm. to see. In some cases, the most expensive first, but you sort by price for sure. It's real. There's some huge innate value when someone's looking for a piece of land somewhere as a potential buyer. So they sort by price and you come to the top.
Right.
I mean, we all know the value of being on the first page of Google. It's the same situation, although, right. you know, you're not getting charged for it here.
Right. I love the MLS myself because for certain properties, especially the higher dollar amounts and the bigger acreage, that's where people are traditionally looking. They will still go look on the MLS for those properties, and you need to be there and show up for them to find you.
Exactly. Today's topic, how to sell and record the same day. This is the meat of the show. Go ahead.
Okay. Okay. So what we're talking about is, and it's funny, people don't realize how easy and how simple this is, that so many counties are coming online and having online recording. So you can literally have someone check out. You could wake up in the morning, see someone has checked out online for your property, and if you did it, you know, correctly, you have it all where they can fill in how they want the deed prepared. So you could have the deed done and recorded online in the same day. Everybody wins. Your seller wins because they love, like, wow, not, I own it. It's done.
Yeah.
And you win because it's not a long drawn out process too. You're not, you know, literally printing it out. You are printing out a deed and signing it, but then you're scanning it, uploading it, and just goes straight to the county. You have to mail it in and wait for them to take their time to record it, because we know some of them can take a little time.
The industry standard, the real estate industry standard for possession, real estate possession, they believe anyway, and you can debate this. When you own a piece of property, the moment you purchase that you own a piece of property is the moment that it gets recorded. Those things are synonymous. Is that actually true in reality? Probably not. But that's what everybody believes. That's what all lawyers believe and real estate agents and buyers and sellers. So it's really cool. And what does recorded mean? It means that the property has been assigned by the county a book and a page number. Back in the day before computers, you would walk into a county and you would see all these books and books and books and three ring binders. And what they are is recorded deeds with a book and a page number. So it could be book 372, page 716. And that's where the deed is for the property that you own. Mm-hmm. So they still use that terminology, a book and mm-hmm. a page number. It's just all electronic now. Mm-hmm. And it's a sticker with the barcode that they slap right on the deed. So that can all happen moments. I mean, when we bought that townhouse that we have in Scottsdale, mm-hmm. I went to the closing myself. It was one of probably the last physical closing I've ever been to. Mm-hmm. And I was actually shocked. The title agent had the keys in her hand. The agent dropped off. The real estate agent had keys in her hand.
To drive up to the recorder?
Hold on. The title agent had her keys in her hand. And she said, hold on 1 second. And she said, bang. She printed out a sticker and put it on my deed and said, you now own it.
Okay, good.
It was truly amazing.
Okay, because not all of them are that up to date.
Usually when everything, back in the day when everything was done, to get a book and a page number, you had to get a courier.
Yeah.
And they would take all the documents from the title office down to the county. It would get recorded and then they would come back. So, it would happen in days, not in seconds.
What were the keys in the hand? That's what that's the keys in the hand for.
Real estate agent dropped off the keys to the place.
Oh.
To the title agent.
Keys in the hand.
But she wouldn't give me the keys until she had a book and page number.
I thought keys in the hand because she's like, I'm going to run this down to their county myself. I'm like, all right. Or then I thought when you said, no, that's not what that meant. Then I thought, okay, keys in hand. Like, okay, are you done? Because we're getting a drink. That was my other thought process.
How do drinks get into this?
Because we're done. Celebrate. That's what I thought. Don't you do that?
Yes, I drink.
No. Don't tell me this is not true. Question. Do you or do you not still celebrate like the old-fashioned way celebrate some real estate transactions?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. That's what I thought with keys in hand.
I absolutely do. That was not a celebratory acquisition.
I didn't say church key in hand. You didn't say church key in hand. That would have been good.
You know, it's funny you ask me that because you were there when I celebrate.
No, I'm going to do it. We'll
do it together.
I'm going to start asking that. What kind of keys? How would it tell? Were they boat keys in hand?
You know what? Actually, like 2 years from now, maybe less, the word key is going to be obsolete.
Right?
I don't have any more keys, do you?
Shucks, no, I don't, because I follow you around.
You don't have a car key.
I don't have a car key.
You don't have house keys.
No, it's a little thing that sticks in my purse, and I just get in the car and push a button.
Exactly.
You're right. There's not going to be keys. This is going to be really weird.
Hey, we know your time's valuable. Thanks for spending some of it with us today anyway. Join us next time for an episode with member JT Olmsted and how he shares his Land Academy success stories.
Yes. And we answer your questions posted on our online community found at landinvestors.com. It is free.
You are not alone in your real estate ambition.
That's good. All
right, we're getting the hang of this.
I think so.
We're getting the hang of the silly outdoor studio thing.
You know, I forgot to give a very, 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 very valuable announcement yesterday, so I'm going to do it right now today. And it may have already happened. actually, it's coming up in about 2 hours now that I think about it. We're going to be live on Facebook today. It's going to be a very kind of business-like yet informative. What's the right term?
Informative.
Informative. Show. So check us out. Join. The topic today is, this is the first time reading it too, by the way. I didn't know what the topic was. Our team just handed it to me. Join Steve and Jack Butala and Jill DeWitt from Land Academy as they discuss how to get started flipping land and houses. And we will also be covering Parcel Fact, using Parcel Fact 2.0 and due diligence. Boy, they're throwing a lot in there. That's going to be good. So that's today, Facebook Live. I think it's like 5 o'clock Pacific time. Go check out Land Academy Facebook page and you'll find the details there.
This is the first time I've heard of, I've been aware, been made aware that I'm going to be involved in a live event.
Surprise.
Good meeting, Jill.
You're welcome. I do it like this and you can't say no. Wherever you're watching, wherever you are listening, please subscribe and rate us there.
We are Steve and Jill. Information
and inspiration
to buy undervalued property.